is a correlation. I want them soldiers who went away and broke.
I look at people, I always ask the question, I say, man, tell me what Nike stands for. They said, oh, Inc., that's easy, just do it. I said, tell me what Adidas stands for. Oh, Inc., that's easy, man, impossible is nothing. I said, now tell me what you stand for. When people look at you, do they think excuses? When people look at you, do they think victory? When people look at you, do they think that's a person that's going to give me everything they got, not on some days, but on every day, and it's not going to be predicated upon if I feel like it? Because I think we all know if we only worked on the days when we felt like it, none of us would get much accomplished. I'm talking about the real level of commitment. Not the commitment that falls in line if everything goes right. I'm speaking of the commitment that says, I am going to stay true to what I said I would do long after the mood that I've set it in has left.
See, most people, ladies and gentlemen, are stoppable. Most people, all you have to do is tell them no. All you have to do is make it inconvenient for them. All you have to do is make it difficult for them, and they're stuck. See, when you go to get your goal, don't think that all you have to do is think positive and everything's going to work out okie-dokie for you. When you go to get your goal, you are sending a telegram to Murphy's Law to visit you personally.
You thought you was just going to have a dream and a goal, and you were just going to wake up and just walk into the sunset. You're like, dream, boom. It don't work like that. You have a dream, and then life punks you. Life punks you and say, do you really want this? You gonna lose friends. Do you really want this? Do you really want this? Cousins gonna abandon you. People that you used to be like this with gonna think you bougie and don't wanna deal with you. It's a part of it, but I paid too much. If I was gonna quit, I would've quit in the abandoned building when I wanted to commit suicide and take my life. I should've quit when I heard my voice say, your mama don't want you, your daddy don't want you, take your life. I got through that, so why I'm gonna quit over F on a grave? Come on. And so I'm telling y'all, you have come too far to quit now. You have invested too much to quit now. You have lost too much to quit now. Don't cry about it. Don't whine about it. Get a reward for your pain.
And so by being committed to everything that I started, I finished it. It built a certain type of spirit. It built a certain type of mentality. It built a certain type of individual. And so now I couldn't quit even if I wanted to. I couldn't stop even if I wanted to. I had too much sweat equity in my life and everything that I was doing.
You're too close to quit now. You gotta take another lap. You gotta take another lap. Cause you never know. This might be the one. You can't stop cause you're tired. You can't stop cause you got your feelings hurt. You gotta take another lap. Keep walking, keep walking, keep walking. You're gonna make it, you're gonna do it. You got an unstoppable fire. Come on, take another lap. Don't you stop, don't stop walking.
Mental toughness is a lot different than motivation. Because if I said right now, everybody in here, everybody, we're all gonna run a half marathon in 5 days, all of us. And we all going, yeah, and we're getting fired up. I said, yeah, we're gonna start tomorrow at 5 a.m. and everyone's hugging each other. Yes, 5 a.m. We leave. 5 a.m. comes. It's dark, it's cold, our bed is comfortable. It's hard to get motivated at 5 in the morning. And maybe you do it one day, but again and again, you'd go do it again and again. That is the X-ray vision. It's seeing through your broken bones to get to your goal. You have to train your brain by doing things that make you uncomfortable consistently to build this mindset that when things get hard, which they will be, we don't shy away, we don't quit, we attack. I'm seeing through all those walls. I'm getting to where I want to go.
You see, I've learned everybody on the face of this planet, they want something. Everybody that comes into this world, they want something. Everybody wants greatness. Everybody wants excellence. But the question is, what are you willing to go through in order to get it? What type of dedication? What type of commitment? What type of sacrifice?
I tell people all the time, if this is not your vision, if you don't see this as part of your real contribution, if it doesn't make you fully alive and express, and it's your real goals, bail. Quit sooner than later. But if you know it's right for you, then resilience is everything. the ability to be resilient toward your dreams, to keep marching on when the struggle, the trial, the chaos, the frustration, the hurt, the anger, the disappointment, the shame, the regret, the embarrassment, when all that is there and you keep marching on, you know you'll be a successful person. It's the ability to be optimistic enough to know this too shall pass. This time shall change. I will find a way. I will honor my truth and keep pursuing my dreams. Thick and thin, storm or night, I will maintain my march.
Mental toughness says, not only do I climb that doggone mountain, I enjoy climbing the mountain. I get a kick out the mountain. I get a kick out the weights. I get a kick out of going up against the number one team. I get a kick out of fatigue. I get a kick out of the grind. I get a kick out of it.
I hope that you understand that every single person that you look at, every single person that you admire, every single person that you aspire to be like is literally just a regular human fucking being like you that has worked their motherfucking ass off.
Now it's gonna be hard. Understand that. It's gonna be very hard. But you ain't got nothing else to do. Cause let me tell you something about being not successful. Being not successful, that's really hard. So you might as well apply yourself to something that has a benefit. And what some of you doing wrong, you play the game, but you not the game. You play football, but you not football. You gotta go all in. You take advantage of this opportunity. You let everything else go. You eat different. You study different. You practice different.
That is something that is built and ingrained into a successful person, not because they were lucky with it, not because they grew up with it, because they developed it. By doing it once, they did it again, they did it again, they did it again. The more bold and courageous you are, the more bold and courageous you'll be in the future. The more confident you are today, the more confident you'll be in the future. The more you overcome yesterday's struggles today, the more you'll be able to overcome the bigger struggles tomorrow. Never forget these things. Keep marching, my friend.